sorry.
Yeah. 3 cups of water, warm water. I'm just gonna let the water run here to get it warm. And then I'm gonna set my thingy to stir it on like 40 degrees. Can somebody tell me how much 110 to 115 Fahrenheit is in Celsius, guys? 41, perfect. Perfect, that's what I thought. So we're putting in 3 cups of water. There we go. With the yeast, and then how long did they say to let it? So what else do we need? We need to add in a nice one, combine sugar, salt, yeast mixture, 3 cups of flour. Okay. That's easy. So what we need? We need flouroni. We need sugar, salt. That's it. So 2 tablespoons of sugar. I'm gonna mix that in here already while it's heating up. 1, 2. Whenever you mix yeast with sugar, it's most of the time that you feed the yeast with the sugar so it can grow more. Then it says 2 tablespoons of salt, so I'm just gonna crack some salt in there. So I'm just cracking a bunch of salt in here. There we go. And then, then we need 3 cups of flour. We're gonna stop the machine. And now we're gonna put in 3 cups of flour. Again, you can just mix all of that by hand, right? You don't need to. So we have 1, 2, and a third one. And that's all my flour gone. Rip flour. And the thing is, I have with this machine a kneading option, so it's just gonna knead the dough for me because I am one lazy person. Where is it? It's the kneading one. There we go. And it says you should mix it for around 3 minutes. So I'm gonna let this machine. Oh, wait. Yeah, actually, it's fine. I have the thing here. I'm gonna let it knead in here. That's neat, right? Sorry. So. Okay, perfect. That should be fine. That doesn't look like it's enough flour. What the heck? Oh, that's just the beginning. Oh, there's more flour that needs to go into this. Just 3 minutes with 3 cups. I was like, wow, that's liquidy. There's more flour that comes into this now. Give me 1 second. I just need to get some flour because I actually have it here. We need more flour. So it's actually way more than that. So the first 3 and then the remaining flour to form a soft dough. Between 6.5. Wait, is that additional? Okay, I see. So 3 cups first and now another 3.5 cups that we need to add. I was like, holy shit, that's a little bit liquidy. So we're adding another, oops. That was a lot. Another 3 cups of flour. That should be fine. Oh my god, and I spilled some. Okay, now the dough looks fantastic, guys. It looks real good now. Gonna throw away the paper. Do you see how it's like turning? Perfect. Can somebody tell me how much is 500 degrees Fahrenheit in Celsius? Please don't move, sir. Oh my god, it's like going crazy. Holy shit. Holy shit, dude, are you okay? Looks fantastic and it smells good though. 260, thank you. So yeah, we're gonna need a bowl because the dough needs to west a little bit so the dough doesn't stick too bad. We're gonna wipe the bowl with a little bit of oil. I would recommend you do that whenever you're putting a dough to rest that is pretty sticky. You want to oil the bowl that you're gonna put it in. I think the dough is gonna be done by now. Yeah, we're looking good. It's a little sticky. Little sticky boy. Look, that's our what our dough looks like. Gonna add a little bit more flour maybe because it's pretty sticky. Oh yeah, that's the consistency we need. I'm gonna just try to get all the dough from the edges as well. Look at this bad boy. When do you have your next holidays, Mama? I'm just gonna knead it a little bit by hand. So, what you wanna do is you wanna fold it in each other. It's like this nice round, do you see this? That's where you want it to be. And we're gonna put the what is it called? The scar on the bottom, kinda. And that's how we're gonna let it rest. We're gonna take a towel. We're gonna cover it. We're gonna put it under the sun here. We're gonna tell, hey Siri. Hey Siri. Set a timer for 30 minutes. Perfect. So now the we're gonna let the dough rise a little bit. Meanwhile, I'm just gonna throw away the rest of the dough that I have here in my sink. Okay, tomato soup. We need a pot, obviously. We start with a shit ton. That's just how I make the tomato soup. I know that a lot of people make it differently, but so we're gonna need onion and garlic, preferably a lot, a big knife. So we're just chopping the onion pretty small. It doesn't have to be perfect because I'm gonna puree the soup in the end anyway. But yeah, you can just chop it fine. We're just gonna glaze it a little bit. Not gonna eat the ass of the onion. We're all plebs to him. Wow, 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 wow. So I'm putting, put this up for you. So we're putting our onions in. I can turn this off. I don't think I'm gonna need this. Onions. Okay, so we're gonna start already glazing the onion. I'm gonna turn the stove on like a middle heat. We wanna get them like in a nice glassy kind of state. So I'm gonna add some. Where is my olive oil? Give me a second. Oh my god, never mind. I don't need to get up like this anymore because I have this thing now. So I don't need to look stupid while I try to get up to get my stuff right. Oh, that's the wrong one. Where's my olive oil? Hello? Olive oil? There we go, the good stuff. We got the good. The good olive oil. The onion is already going. Oh yes. And turn it even a little bit down because I don't want necessarily browning. I just want it to be like glassy kind of. And now, the important part, my friends. We need the tomato. And also I want, where is it? This. So, for my tomato soup, I use obviously fresh tomatoes. I use some big ones. I use some small ones. I just like to have like different flavors. Like usually big ones are sometimes a little bit watery. And small ones are a little bit more intense in taste. But we're gonna be mixing it up. We're gonna use a lot of different tomatoes. Or two different ones. So little cherry tomatoes and try to get like meaty tomatoes with not that much water for the taste. And then I also gonna use some sun-dried tomatoes to add even a little bit more taste. You could obviously sun-dry them yourself, or you just get the ones from the shop, obviously. Just gonna make sure nothing is burning, so we're gonna keep mixing. And now we're gonna start cutting our tomatoes. There we go. Now we add in the rest of the tomatoes. I don't really know. I didn't weigh it like how much tomatoes I cut or anything. just letting you know and just eyeball everything. So this still middle heat. What I'm doing right now, I'm gonna add some salt to it that makes the tomatoes release more liquid and obviously for the taste later. The sugar we're gonna be adding, we can actually add it now already, kind of. That's a lot of tomatoes, yeah. It's gonna be a soup. So I'm gonna use up my sun-dried tomatoes that I have left over. Mmm, they smell so good, I love it. Sorry. I don't know why I had to burp. Excuse-moi. There we go. I don't know, I'm just using the ones that I have left. I like it because it gives a little bit of a different flavor to the soup later on. Those ones, again, I'm just roughly chopping those. And now we just put those in as well. Now we can also add the sugar. Again, you don't have to, but it's usually what makes a dish feel like more round. So since we have quite some tomatoes in there, I'm just gonna do like a generous, like this, some sugar, yes. Now, you can technically already add some spices to it if you want. I usually puree everything first and then I taste. And also what I do with my tomato soup, I always put some fresh basil in. If you don't have fresh basil, what else you can do? Like the dried one, I'm not a fan, to be honest. You could get some basil pesto or something. If you don't have, that's a lot of sugar. Yeah, but it's also a lot of tomatoes, so. So fresh basil, I have a big basil plant here, which we're gonna harvest some. If you want your basil to grow back, the best thing is if you always pick from the top. Not from the bottom. For the soup, for example, I'm not afraid to take also like the little, what is it called? The stem, like the little, this one. Like I don't only use the leaves, I use everything of the basil. You can obviously use way more basil if you want to. That's I think a good amount for me. The stem, exactly, thank you. So yeah, I'm using the stems as well because they're really full of flavor. This is looking fantastic already. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add the basil pretty late because I don't wanna overcook it because then the whole flavor is out, kinda. So I'm using my little Hitachi Wonder wand, I'm kidding. It's like a little mixed puree stick, I don't know. How do you call those? I forgot what they're called. So yeah, and what we're gonna do now, we're gonna puree everything. There we go. Careful, might be loud, team. Close your ears.
One minute, 37 seconds later. 5 minutes later.
Want to make sure to get all the pieces. I mean, it's depending. You can have like a chunky consistency too, but I like mine really smooth, so.
Two thousand years later.
And now we taste out. Oh, it's a little bit too hot. I need to turn it down. Oh my god, yes. I wish you could taste it. And it's so simple, you know? Oh my god, it's still spritzing everywhere. I'm gonna add a little bit of this, okay? So, cream. I'm not using heavy cream. I'm just using, it's like 15% cream. 15% fat cream. And I don't know, I'm not really measuring, okay? I'm just tasting. Obviously, as soon as you mix some more in, you're gonna have to readjust the spices and stuff. Oh, this is so good already. But yeah, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put like, what is that? This is like 250 ml of cream is what I added so far. And now I'm just gonna let it not boil, but like simmer for a little bit. And then I'm gonna decide, and now it's nice and liquidy, more like a soup, less like a tomato sauce. Probably gonna have to add more salt. I'm gonna add some oregano to it as well. I'm gonna add some more salt to it before we let it simmer. Some pepper, obviously. And then I'm gonna add some oregano to it. Is it oregano or is it oregano in English? Yeah, we're gonna add some oregano to it. Thinking about some majoran. If you want a little bit of majoran, then we mix. Yep. I have basil already in. So I'm just gonna add a little bit more of like pureed tomatoes, just for the consistency, because with the, you don't have to do that, but it's like just so I have a little bit of more soup later, because Jess is gonna be here as well. Since that is again a lot of tomatoes, I'm gonna have to see if I need to have maybe a little bit more of sugar, but I'm not sure yet. But the consistency looks really good now. So I'm just gonna keep that on a like low to medium heat, and I'm turning on my stove on like 260 degrees. We're gonna do the bread bowls now. Ooh, look at our dough, how big it's going. We're gonna take care of this bad boy now. So I'm not sure how many bread bowls we can make out of it, like four, I guess. Let me see. Six. We can make six bread bowls out of this. Perfect. Soup is already done. I just need to make the bread bowls. So that should be done before your game. Yeah, we can make approximately, they said you can make four in one tray. So let's see. I'm just gonna put a little bit of flour so it doesn't stick. Let's see. So we fold it again onto itself, and now we form the dough balls. I'm just trying to fold it in so we have a nice round top. And now put them on the sheet like this. And now we need to let them rise for 15 more minutes. Now we just cover them for 15 more minutes while the oven is preheating. Hope this one is not too warm. Kind of warm already. It's okay. There we go. In the meanwhile, they're resting. I'm gonna clean up a little bit this mess. Oh, I forgot to cut them. Nobody told me, guys, we forgot to cut them. X's, we need to cut them with... I'm not sure this one is probably not sharp enough. So Jesus. Now they go in, guys. Now we're making our salmon sauce. Salmon sauce. So bechamel, yes or no, guys? Yes. All in, we said, right? Okay, now we're not gonna puree anything. So now, when we cut the onion and everything, we want to make it like really fine already. Then, garlic, again. You can see a pattern here. I didn't put the timer for bread. We're just looking at it, how it's going. But it looks pretty good already. How it's going up. We're gonna turn the heat down a little bit. We're just gonna have to keep checking. Thanks for reminding me, guys. Garlic again. Mince it real fine. Chop, 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 chop. Chop, 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 chop. A little browning already. Okay. I'm also gonna put some oil already. I'm using olive oil again. A little bit more because we're gonna have the salmon later in here as well. And the salmon pasta, and this is like, you can use that as a normal pasta sauce as well. It is so simple, guys. I swear to God, it is legit the simplest dish ever. I got some Nordic salmon. Okay, while I'm gonna cut the salmon, bread looking good. Keep reminding me, guys, please, on the bread. Jesus. Oh, somebody subscribed. Give me a second. Just turning on my stove. We want the garlic and the onion to get glazy. Okay, this sauce, I don't know, we don't need it. I didn't even know that it would come with a sauce. And now I'm just chopping the salmon. So I'm using smoked salmon for this because it's just more flavorful. I like to use it. Ooh, bread looking good. Okay, we got a lot of twash to throw away. And then we said we're gonna make a bechamel sauce, right? I'm gonna be lazy with the bechamel sauce though, and I'm just gonna let my Thermomix make it for me. Garlic and onion, glazing them, nice. So meanwhile, we put the Thermomix on again. There we go. We're gonna make a bechamel sauce in there. Okay, the onions are looking great so far. Also, one thing that you kind of need to be careful with once you make anything with smoked salmon, keep in mind that smoked salmon is already salty. So whenever you make a sauce out of it and stuff, so I'm just adding it to the onions and stuff, make sure that you don't salt until the end, because it just, like, otherwise you might make it too salty. There we go. Now we're just gonna let it sit a little bit. Let me see the bread. Oh yes, this is looking fantastic. I think the bread is looking nice. Let me just poke it and see if the bread is fully done, but it looks like it. So I have some skewers I'm gonna use to poke and see if nothing sticks. It's done. Yes, bread is done. We're gonna take our first breads out. Bredbowls. And I think they have a really nice size, actually. Look. Look at those bad boys. Just want the salmon to be, like, kinda cooked through before we add our sauce with it. Nice buns. Thanks. The bread looks good too, right? Sorry. Okay, perfect. Our salmon is cooked through. This is exactly what we want. I also want to start my bechamel sauce here in my Thermomix. Again, to make a simple bechamel sauce, it's basically just butter, butter, flour, milk. That's all you need for it. I'm just making a standard one in here, which just does everything by itself. So, and then some salt, and I think the mustard is coming, nutmeg is coming in the end. So salt, black pepper, obviously. Also gonna put nutmeg, but yeah, the nutmeg is coming now already. Okay, Nathan wants this one, he said, for his soup. So I use just some cream for the salmon now. Half a liter, approximately, is what I'm using. And then I haven't added any spices yet because I want the, as I already said, the smoked salmon to release, like, all the salty taste in the sauce first. I'm gonna let it simmer a little bit. But what I can add already, which is really important, is some dill. I guess a lot of you already guessed that since salmon and dill go hand in hand. There we go. And now we just let the sauce simmer a little bit. How's our bread looking? Bread looking fine as fuck. We're turning it back a little bit. I'm gonna probably bring Nathan his first bun already. So we're gonna see if we did everything right. I'm just gonna, for safety reasons, I'm gonna put it in a bowl. So what are we gonna do? He wants this one. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut off the top of the bread. So I cut the top off. Whee! So put that to the side, and now we just need to get the insides out. You can see overhead? Yes. And now we're just filling the bread with the soup. Fantastic, guys. Look at this. Look at this plating. Ooh. There you go. Enjoy. Yep. Need to tell me if you like it. Most likely. With that. I'm back, team. Ooh. Ooh. You know what looks done? Our bread. Bread looks done. Just gonna put those buns to the side. Oh, actually, it's still hot. No. Want it? We made full meal picks with those cooking streams. What do you mean? Oh my god. Oh, that's what I mean, yeah. I get it now. Bread is done. Look at those sexy buns. Look at those sexy buns. Yes, exactly, Dark. I'm just gonna put them on the rack to cool down faster. And we're putting this away. Same time. Also could have just let those here. Look at all of those glorious buns though. Let me see. Salmon sauce. Oh, and I also need to close my soup thingy again. Man, the soup is so good. Let me try my salmon sauce now. Now comes the point where I need to add salt and the pepper. So now salt, black pepper, and we mix it, and then we can start almost building our lasagna already. We're having Barilla pasta. So yeah, obviously it's a little bit too long for the normal. There we go. You can break it, don't worry about it. Don't you worry about it. It's getting like bigger towards the top, so that's all fine. Bechamel is almost done. Our salmon sauce is ready, which is really nice. See, bechamel done as well. Look at me. Am I good or am I good in just like timing everything perfectly? I know, guys. Perfect. What do I want? Oh yeah, I want the spinach. Let me get the spinach out. Oh, there we go. Fresh spinach. You can take frozen one as well. I like to make it with the fresh spinach. I'm eating the inside of the bread. So, we're starting. Now we're just layering our lasagna. So, first layer, pasta. Then we're putting our salmon sauce on top. And then once you have the layer, pasta and salmon, now you just put your spinach on top of that. And the spinach is just gonna cook while the lasagna is in the oven, right? And I don't know if Nasu is still here, maybe Lars. Can somebody invite Nikki to the Guild and WoW? Esu maybe? I don't know who's around. I think they're playing Valorant right now. What did you put in the soup to make it yellowish? It's not really yellow, it's orange. Cream. It's tomato and cream. There we go, so we have spinach. And now I just want a little bit of sauce over it so the spinach leaves don't get stuck to the pasta. Doesn't have to be a lot, just a little bit so it separates it, right? Could also do that with the bechamel, technically. But bechamel I'm gonna add a little bit later. And again. Oop. We're just gonna piece it together the way we need it. Doesn't need to be perfect. So now, again, salmon. Salmon sauce. Nathan just wrote me really good for the soup. The man approves. That's important. Okay, so now we have spinach layer, and now my bechamel sauce is done. And now we're gonna spoon in some of the good heavy stuff. Some of the bechamel. Oh yes, make that a thick boy lasagna. Looks healthy, but it's not. We go. Is that enough space yet? Maybe just a corner? Yes. Now we're at this that height that we have the height to make the full on lasagna leaves. Now again, salmon. Woo! Look at this. And now the last layer, put the thingy away, is gonna be just the bechamel sauce. And cheese. You take out everything. Oh my god, guys, this is like next level. Now I can put it in like this, but obviously, my friends, we are fat, so we're gonna top it off with some cheese. I have one open one here that I'm gonna use first. Lactose intolerant, by the way. Yep. This is mozzarella, shredded mozzarella, by the way. How do you make the bechamel in that sauce of yours? It's, look it up, it's a Thermomix. It's basically a kitchen utensil. But the bechamel is basically just butter, flour, milk. There we go, we got the good cheese on top. Here, and I am gonna put my lid on it, and we are going in, and this is gonna be like a good 40-ish minutes, I guess. So that's how it goes. We open it up, soup, turn it on so you can see how I fill it. Ooh yeah, looking delicious. And now for me as well, because I like to plate stuff nice. And I love how basil tastes. Bring some basil on top. Ooh. Look at this bad boy. Oh, look at this bad boy of a soup. Nita, how you doing? Delicious. Man, food is amazing. Oh my god, the salmon lasagna. Let me tell you, try it. It's so good. And if you don't want to do the whole lasagna, just make the salmon sauce. If you have recipes, certain topics or ideas, your favorite dish, the recipe from your grandma, if you want me to cook that, I have a Discord channel. I have a Discord and there's a channel in it where you can suggest recipes that I should cook. So if you would want to do that, feel free to recommend something. Have a beautiful day, guys, and thanks for everything. Bye!